here today have lost a fish before, or any sort of other sort of pets, you know what it's like. I remember when I first met MJ. Before Christmas break last year, my roommate gave to me my Christmas present. I opened it up and it was a fish tank. She said once we get back from break, we will be getting a fish. I was so excited just to come back to school just to get the fish. When she came back into the room, she had with her a little blue betta fish. The betta fish is also known as the Siamese fighting fish, and they're known to easily adapt in changing environmental conditions and can breathe oxygen through the air by going up to the surface. MJ brought joy to not only my life and my roommate's life, but to the others in 5G, who would always be wanting to come in and see how he's doing. However, one thing you probably didn't know is that MJ, he was very picky about his food. Betta fish are typically carnivorous and have different types of food that they can eat. They can eat pellets, dried worms, or flakes. MJ would always be spitting out his pellets and not even touching the dried worms, so he would only have to eat his flakes. MJ was also very sassy. He would always be flaring up his gills at people whenever they got nearest him. Sadly, MJ suffered from a condition called fin rot. Fin rot is a bacterial infection where the fins turn black or even bloody, and it's caused by poor water quality. MJ's fins started turning black, and he actually ended up losing part of them, so he had trouble swimming around. We almost thought he died a couple times. And people would always be coming into the room to see how he's doing and saying, "Is MJ alive? Is MJ alive?" Naturally, my roommate and I looked up online to see how to cure fin rot. We saw that you either have to clean the tank really well or get medicine. Being the poor college kids we were, we decided to ditch the medicine and just try to clean the tank and hope for the best. After we cleaned the tank very well, MJ actually ended up surviving. We thought he was lonely, so we decided to get him a friend. We got him a little moss ball that we named Linus. Even though moss balls aren't typically good friends, it brought more life to the tank and MJ seemed a little bit happier. We also decided to decorate his tank some more just to make him happy. My roommate got barrels for him that he loved to swim through. MJ actually ended up surviving all throughout last year and even over the summer, so I decided to bring him back for another year at SLIP. He's been touch and go for the past couple of weeks, but he actually ended up surviving up until Thanksgiving break. He was still alive when my mom came down, so we decided to take him back home. He survived all throughout Thanksgiving break, so I left him in the care of my brother before I came back to SLIP. I heard my mom had to tell me the other day that MJ actually ended up dying. MJ had a really rough life, but it was great to know him. Even though he was a survivor of fin rot and a survivor of being cared by college kids at school, he taught me responsibility and he was just a great, good college pet. Thank you, MJ, for always being there.